Hello, welcome, and thank you for watching my review of Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. Now, I know earlier in one of my videos, I can't remember which one, I just have so many, I said that I was seeing it on Friday, but I saw it last night, which is Thursday, because I have a dance for the school to go to tonight, which I don't really want to go to, but my mom convinced me to go. So I changed my tickets for last night, and I saw it last night, and it was really good. Really good. Now, I love ranking movies. I love ranking movies and series. I love ranking franchise, etc., etc., etc. But I've never really been able to rank the Indiana Jones films. Whereas The Lost Ark is a classic. I love it. It's an awesome film. I really like Last Crusade, too. But the dialogue in Temple of Doom is absolutely horrible. The humor is lame. But it has maybe some of the best action in the whole series. So I've just had trouble making a balance. But this one probably isn't my favorite. Raiders of the Lost Ark is probably my favorite, no surprise. But this one really is very good. But I do expect disappointment from some big fans, because it really just does not seem like an Indiana Jones film. The characters stay the same. Harrison Ford still has it. It's not, the magic isn't lost or anything. It's just really over the top. Think along the lines of that scene in The Last Crusade when Indy bumps into Hitler and gets his autograph. I've always thought that was a little goofy scene. There's a lot of stuff like that. But I like how they acknowledge the fact that's low, where they're going, oh man, I can't believe that happened. They're not just acting like it's normal, because that'd be really messed up. So they did well. I enjoyed it. I liked it being over the top. I'm glad they did that, because it was a lot of fun. Some of it did have me rolling my eyes, you know, when Shia LaBeouf's swinging on vines like Tarzan, animated beavers are staring at Indy. Some of it was a little dumb. I'm really glad they brought back the actress from the first film, same character. I didn't know they were doing that until they said it in the film. But them reuniting the romance does seem a little forced. Really rushed. I'm saying they have good chemistry, but once in the shower, the next one he says some one-liner, then they're making out. I'm like, dude, what the heck? Come on, get her phone number first. Shia LaBeouf's really good here. I love this guy. I know a lot of people don't, but he's a really good actor. They showed a trailer for his new movie, Eagle Eye, with Billy Bob Thornton in it, too. I'm really looking forward to that. It comes out one day before my birthday party. Actually, I haven't had a birthday party for 3 years. Anyway, I do expect mixed reviews for this movie. But really, I gotta say, just enjoy it. It does take a turn, the last climax at the end. I didn't really think it worked very well. It seemed like it was in the wrong genre, in the wrong movie. Felt a little out of place. But it doesn't make me forget all the awesome stuff before. And I'm not a sucker for action. You know, it needs to have something more depth. It needs to have some substance, just not action. I didn't even like 300 for crying out loud, because all I thought it was action. The action was good. It looked awesome. But the characters, I thought the filmmakers really struggled with the characters and the depth. And this one had all that. But I'm saying the best part was the action. There's some great fun scenes. It's over the top, it's stupid, it's goofy, but it's awesome. Overall, I give Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull an 8.5 out of 10. I will see you guys later.